kid who sued his parents in court. And he sued his parents for giving birth to him without his consent. Now, the kid didn't stand a chance because both of his parents were lawyers. So the case was eventually thrown out. But some of the defenses the parents gave in the argument was, first of all, we wanted to get your consent, we just couldn't find you. Also, they said, we were also born without our consent. So, you know, a kid could say to his parents, I didn't ask to be born. You know, you told me I got to do this, I got to go to school, I got to get good grades, then I got to go to college, I got to get a job, I got to pay taxes, I have to pay the mortgage, I have to pay the insurance bills. I didn't ask for any of this. You didn't ask me if I want to be born. So, it's interesting. In this week's Torah portion, we find, by the way, this week's Torah portion wins the Guinness World Record of the most commandments in any Torah portion. There are over 70 commandments in this week's Torah portion. No other Torah portion has as many. And there's a variety of laws, obviously. But one law is very unique. It says that if you happen upon a nest with little chicks and the mother bird, and you want to take the eggs, you want to take the baby chicks, so the Torah says you're allowed to, because you're allowed to take the eggs. However, the mother's sitting on the eggs. Don't take the mother with the eggs. Send away the mother before you take the eggs. And there's a famous dispute between Maimonides and Nachmanides. What's the reason behind this commandment? Maimonides says it's compassion. The worst thing for a parent, God forbid, is to see the death or the demise of their child. The worst human suffering. And the Torah is saying it's not just in human beings. Animals have those emotional feelings too. And if you take away the babies in the presence of the mother, that's the cruel pain to the mother. And therefore send the mother away. She shouldn't see the way you take away her chicks, her babies. That's Maimonides. Nachmanides says it's about ecology. It's about sustainable living. Just like last week it says you shouldn't cut down a fruit tree because it bears fruit. Man is like a tree in the field. Imagine you go and you take the fruit from a tree and then you chop down the tree. You uproot the tree. You took the fruit, that's fine, but let the tree produce more fruit in the future. Don't cut down the source. Same thing, don't take the mother. You're taking the chicks, but let the mother reproduce more with the father. In other words, extinction of species. Don't allow the species to be eradicated by taking the mother. But there's another way to look at this, and that is, there's something very unique. Of all the commandments in the Torah, there are only two commandments where we're promised a reward at all, and that reward is long life. One is in the Ten Commandments, honor your father and mother, and one is about sending away the mother bird. So that tells you there's a connection between these two commandments. And one of the explanations is as follows. If I told you, go outside and catch a bird, you think you'll catch a bird? No, because if you try to catch a bird, the bird flies away. So how is it that you're able to even take the mother bird in the first place? When the mother bird sees you coming to get the bird, she should fly away. You know why she doesn't fly away? Because she's ready to sacrifice her life to protect her young. So the Torah says, honor the love and the devotion and the sacrifice of a mother to its young. Don't take advantage of her self-sacrifice. Don't take advantage of her vulnerability that she loves her children so much that she stayed behind to protect her young. Don't exploit that. Let the mother go free. And that's the lesson why you get long life. Because the Torah is telling us, you know, when it comes to your parents, guess what? Your parents are waiting for your phone call. They need your phone call. That's the way it works. It's not only that you need your parents need you because they're emotionally bonded with you. And when you don't give them the proper love and respect, it pains them. And therefore, don't exploit their love for you and take advantage of that and ignore it. And be indifferent to it. Realize that that is the greatest gift that God gave you, a loving parent. And therefore honor that love and cherish that love and respect it. And show your parents the proper love. Because if you don't, you're causing them anguish because they need your love. And the same thing is true with God. You know, God is our Father in heaven. We're going to the high holidays now. Most people think religion is, you know, you need God. And God says you have to do this and you have to do this and you have to do that. And if you don't do this, you're going to get, you know, God forbid, punished. Judaism is much more deeper than this. Judaism says, no, it's not that you need God. Of course you need God. That's obvious. But you know what else? God needs you. He loves you like a child. And when you ignore God, it causes him pain and anguish. Just like if you don't call your mother for a year, your mother's in pain. If you don't show up to shul for a year, God says, you're my beautiful child. Why don't you talk to me? Why don't you give me a call? Why don't you show up? I love you. Come visit me once in a while. So God needs you, and therefore God created you with love, gives you life with love. Honor that love, cherish that love, respect that love. Don't ignore it, don't be indifferent to it. And so the answer is, when the parents, the kid says to the parent, I didn't need to be born. Kid's right, he didn't need to be born. The Talmud actually asks, is it better for a person to have been born or not in the first place? Had you not been born, you wouldn't even know what you're missing. Now that you're born, you got all these worries, all these problems, all these stresses, all these anxieties. So people walk around all day thinking, I need this, I need that, what do I need, what do I need to do? Stop thinking about what you need. Think about the fact that what does God need you for? God put you here because He needs you. And you have the greatest privilege of giving God the nachas, just like a child has the privilege of giving their parents nachas. You have tremendous power as a child. Your parents' happiness is very much dependent on how you treat them and how you act. When they're proud of you, you give them so much joy. And if not, you cause them embarrassment and pain. Realize God needs you just as much. And JFK once said it best when he said, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. But actually the Alter Rebbe, Rav Shneur Zalman of the Leadi, the founder of Chabad Hasidism, said it 200 years ago. When a chassid came to him with a letter, with all the things he needed, the Alter Rebbe looked up at him, and in Yiddish he said, "The zuchst als was du darfst." You tell me throughout the letter everything you need, but it was darf min dir, but what are you needed for? People would be a lot happier if they spent their days not constantly thinking about what they need, but what am I needed for? Why did God create me? What did He want from me? If He put me here, put me here for a purpose. And when you focus on what you're needed for, rather than what you need, you're obviously much happier, and you make God much happier as well.